Boston Bruins Hockey on Nesson is brought to you by Geico, by Ace Ticket, by Toyota, by Dunkin' Donuts, by New England Ford, and by K-Bear. Rene Rancourt brings the faithful to their feet. It's the Bruins and the Red Wings in a matinee at TD Garden.
To 90 years of Bruins hockey. To begin our year-long celebration, today we honor the great Bruin teams of the 1940s, a decade where incumbent dominance on the ice was tested by times of war. Here to perform today's ceremonial puck drop, please join us in welcoming a legendary Bruins player, coach, GM, and Hockey Hall of Famer.
That wasn't a special person. God bless him. He was tough.
He was one of the great players in the history of the city of Pittsburgh.
Everybody idolized Bill Smith.
A gentleman at all times. Hello.
Ladies and gentlemen, the ultimate Bruin, Bill Smith. Will both captains please come forward for today's ceremonial puck drop?
Milt Schmidt is what we all should want to be. What a great man. Today's starting goalie is brought to you by your local New England Audi dealers. Experience Audi Quattro all-wheel drive today. Jonas Gustafsson, a late change. It looks as if Jimmy Howard was going to be the starter for Detroit, but the ex-Maple Leaf, who had a lot of groin problems last year and only had four decisions, will get the nod this afternoon against Tuukka Rask, who made 25 saves in a 4-1 win against this Red Wings team on the 5th of October. That time, the Red Wings are playing the third game in three cities in 4 days. This time, both clubs rested. The game is on. This ought to be a really good contest, Brick.
Well, Detroit certainly wants to make a better showing than they did last time. And yes, it was a scheduled loss maybe for Detroit. But they're coming off a pretty good performance against the Flyers. Their power play now seems to be kicking into gear a little bit. They just have too much talent, really, especially in Datsyuk and Zetterberg, for that power play to be dormant. So I expect certainly a totally different team, Red Wings, this afternoon.
Yes, the translation of kicking into gear is going 3-for-7 at Philadelphia on Saturday, and that's a scary thing. And like the Bruins, Detroit has made some changes up front. You'll be seeing Todd Bertuzzi, as he did on that first shift, skating with Datsyuk and Zetterberg, where we had seen Justin Applegator in the first meeting of these two teams. That plays offside. It'll come back to center. But there is no complacency with the Mike Babcock team, nor is there with the depth the Bruins have this year with Claude Julien.
Did he have that Clint Eastwood look again this morning, Jack?
I want to know who's going to give in. Somebody gives in every game. I want to know. But what a great coach. You know, it's wonderful to be around Claude Julien every day. A little bit of debris on the ice I'm going to have to clean up. It's wonderful to be around Claude Julien every day because he is a teacher of the game and he loves to teach the game. And never an arrogant attitude about any question that might come his way, even though it could get shot down in other quarters, even in this city and some other professional sports venues. But Babcock is much the same way. He starts with his love of the game, his passion for it, and his willingness to go to the wall as he consults with Tom Rennie, another guy who's got a pretty good resume. And to teach this game, and to make his players better, and to make his team supreme if he can. Well, whatever it was, egg yolk or whatever, it's gone.
Yeah, it had that hue to it, didn't it?
Yeah. Sending the omelet back to the kitchen, I guess. I don't know. So David Krejci with Jerome McGinley right and Milan Lucic left. You notice the Bruins in their men in black alternate sweaters. Dennis Seidenberg back on the right side with Matt Barkowski on the left. Dougie Hamilton again, a healthy scratch for the Bruins. Barkowski takes the space, but in the linesman's judgment, the Bruins are offside.
Yeah, David Krejci all the way across the width of the ice in the right wing slot after this faceoff. Just that slight little hesitation by Barkowski. I think the anticipation was hard wraparound, but all of a sudden he had some space. He had some ice to take it. He took it. And David Krejci maybe in the zone a little bit too quick.
Kim Anderson gets thrown out of the faceoff. Daniel Alfredson recently bumps down to the third line for Detroit. Steps in to take it. Rask steers the puck to Matt Barkowski around to Dennis Seidenberg. Rims it around. That connects with nobody, and we'll have our third stoppage. Well, yes, we will, but boy, it sure seemed as if Gustafsson was out there to play the puck, but they're going to rule the hybrid icing anyway.
Drop this at the center ice dot.
Yeah, they're going to. Yep. Help me on that one, Rick, because it sure seemed as if Gustafsson was way out to play that.
He was.
Before the players got anywhere near the faceoff dot.
There was going to be a hybrid icing. The linesmen were both trying to be on the same page, but then when the goaltender Gustafsson made a move, it gets waved off. The linesman on the other end decided to blow it down.
Well, this is stalling the car in the driveway for the start of this game. Alfredson chips the puck off the boards and bounces over Lucic's stick, but sits flat, something we didn't see a lot of on Saturday. McGillan cocks and fires and drives it right into Nicholas Cronwall's legs. Lucic, the diagonal for Krug, backs along the line, wrists it right into Anderson's legs, and Anderson flicks to center. Seidenberg guns it back in, quick re-entry as the Bruins want to change. And the fresh bodies will come over the boards. Marchand skating on the off wing on Chris Kelly's right with Jordan Caron flipping to the left. The bank pass, long for Advocator. He sends it off a stance and it dies in the circle for Kelly. Advocator finishes his check on Kelly, who takes the hit to move it to Marchand, but Stephen Weiss digs it away. Adam McQuaid past Advocator. Caron has to come back as Kindle pinches in. Bronson rotating to the point, comes along the line to Brian Lashoff, Matt's little brother, throws it off the corner boards, past Kindle. Reach. That's a race for the puck. And Kindle angles off Caron. And that's not interference. Okay.
I
is you can possess the puck that was slid by you even though it's 20 feet away. I'm a little clueless about that one.
Then Marchand had a chance to go get it first, but he thought Caron clearly had open ice and the angle to make a play on that loose puck. But when he gets angled off by Kindle, now the Red Wings end up with possession when Marchand could have had it first.
It's a government center green line change at the Red Wings bench, but no whistle on that one. And let's go back and look at that play just inside the ring, the Wings line.
No, it starts with a shot from the left point. Lashoff misses on the wide side, and now because of the active defense is that riding off by Kindle on Caron. Hard to believe there was no interference call there. But you could clearly see that Marchand had a chance to look at that puck, but his read was Caron's got it. He's got an open lane to the puck. The only way he won't get it is if he's interfered with.
Here comes Daniel Paille working for Danny DeKeyser. McQuaid comes off the boards, throws it low for Thornton in front. Gustafson will have to hang on. Thornton keeping Gustafson honest, having him pull away from the post.
Yeah, nice play by Thornton. Good decision, too, by McQuaid when that puck comes wrapped around. And Thornton's pitching down the wall on the forecheck. When it goes all the way to the point, McQuaid wanted to go D-to-D, but he really doesn't have a better play. So he wisely makes a possession pass down to Thornton. Thornton, again, a good decision. Got Paille working the blue paint, put it on goal.
500 games for Sean Thornton. Boy, Chuck's wrist shot and a leg save by Gustafson. Chara snaps the puck away from Bertuzzi, but the Bruins are caught inside the attacking zone. Neither team has a rhythm here for this 1 p.m. start.
Well, pretty good faceoff win and a good wrist shot by Johnny Boychuk. The game in Columbus, the Bruins' points go wide open. We've seen Detroit already make a couple of blocks, one by a forward, one by a defenseman on the last shift with the Krejci line on the ice. But Boychuk used that quick wrist shot to make sure there was a lane to the net. Gustafson had to get it.
Now Quincy chips to the end boards. A good read by Chara. Hops right around Bertuzzi to win the puck. Bergeron rotating back. Hammers it off the kick plate. Riley Smith trying to angle middle. Quincy rides him off. But there's Bergeron with Datsyuk on him. A classic matchup. Erickson back to Chara. The quick release wrist shot. Bounces off the post with Smith creating traffic in front. Riley Smith doing a good job in front of Gustafson. Getting manhandled but keeping himself in position to make a deflection. Long bouncing pass for Zetterberg up ice. Boychuk patient, rides him off. Chara back on the angle. And Bertuzzi ends up with nothing alone in the slot. Bergeron off the boards in this game, has a pulse now.
Yeah, real good shift by Riley Smith, Jack. And not just getting to the front of the net, but one-on-one battles, protecting the puck below the goal line, allowing Bergeron the time to get in there, lend support, puck possession, use the points, and then get to the front of the net.
Alfredson, the self-pass down into Barkowski's corner. Barkowski with some good speed on the strides. Kindle on the near side draws. Cronwell gets it to Krejci. Saucers it around Cleary. But a good defensive play. Erickson on the angle. Ahead to Cronwell, who's just now getting back. The defenseman, the last man back. Detroit changes out. Let's go Bruins, the chant from the TD Garden crowd. Barkowski weaving to the center circle, runs into Abdelkader. It's a three-on-two up ice. Abdelkader for Franz, and he sweeps it over the top as it ramps up off a stick. I think Boychuk got the way. Ekinla working forward against Lashoff, goes for the wrist shot, flex off Lashoff to the corner. Ekinla tosses the backhand to the near corner. Chris Kelly, now Marchand with Weiss on his back. Kelly comes off the boards. Good adjustment by Boychuk. Chara with a monster reach. Keeps it on the line. Marchand turns to goal. The shot saved. Rebound loose. Kelly whacks it just past the post as Franz was bearing down on him. Boychuk has to hold it outside the line. Abdelkader green-lighted him. Boychuk knew it was coming, and he took a big hit to dump the puck back in.
Yeah, it looked like Chara got to that rebound all the way from the left point check.
The Bruins activating the defenseman. And some good reads. Chara, one against two, and it's bowling pins in the corner. Now can the Bruins capitalize as they have numbers up ice? Kelly to Marchand with Caron cutting across the middle of the line. They're onside. The quick shot by Marchand is saved by Gustafson. Loose puck in the corner. Caron goes after it, and it bounces up. Now here comes Luke Glendening. Glendening making his debut at TD Garden, just his second game for the Wings. He played in Philadelphia. Real hard worker. He was 2 years a captain at the University of Michigan. Jordan Tutu dumps the puck down into the corner. McQuaid, the hard backhand around, comes all the way to the blue line. A good pitch by Erickson, or at least a stop by Erickson with the side escape. Thornton in a battle along the wall. Up but not out. Cronwall, high slot. Miller, the quick release and a stick save by Tuukka Rask with some x-ray vision through the screen. Campbell whips it off. Paille's stick. It deflects all the way past Erickson, and that'll be icing against Boston.
Now, some pretty good opportunities for Boston prior to the tail end of this shift where Detroit established a forecheck. Riley Smith doing a nice job protecting pucks and then getting to the front of the net on a good wrist shot by Chara. Deflection off the post. Bruins again using that defense standing in at the blue line. You see Chara on the follow-up after Marchand made the right play. He knew he had space. He knew he had lane to the net on that short side. Trying to get his own rebound. Put it low and then put it up high on your self-rebound, self-shot. And then Chara on the follow-up.
High in the neutral zone. Jimmy Howard not on the Detroit bench in the accustomed backup goaltender's position opening the door. We don't know what the situation is. But obviously Gustafson in the game and Howard right now nowhere to be seen. Todd Bertuzzi rotates it back.
He's still sick after that Red Sox.
Zetterberg in the off wing tosses the backhand toward Datsyuk. Angles it wide. Bergeron after Zetterberg. Datsyuk can't get the backhand through Boychuk. Chara takes the puck to the corner, draws Datsyuk. Awful leg and it bounces to Bergeron. Erickson. It deflects off Erickson. Little Erickson on Erickson violence there. Zetterberg patient with the puck, flips the backhand off the blocker. Looked as if he was looking for rebound all the way. Pretty clever play by Henrik Zetterberg. 12:14 to go first period. Zdeno Chara's wake-up call. I'll have a couple of wings with breakfast.
Period. Detroit, Boston. Riley Smith playing on the left side with Bergeron. Erickson on the right. Doing a terrific job getting it on the forecheck, using the points. Once you make the pass, don't stand still. Make yourself available. He stays along the wall, gets the return pass. He protects it along the boards, allows Bergeron to come in and lend that support. Now get to the front of the net when it does get back to that left point. Good battle with Quincy. We're going to get a piece of that. It catches the post. Hard-working shift by a guy that is starting to get more and more comfortable in the Bruins uniform.
He's finding his way pretty quickly, isn't he? His older brother, Brendan Smith, a healthy scratch for Detroit this afternoon, so they will not play against one another. Seidenberg sends the puck around with Alfredson chasing. Lucic, the long diagonal with Cronwall, battling Ginland. The puck comes loose to Dan Cleary. He scoots it into Seidenberg's corner. The apron of the goal. Ekinla saucers the pass to Krejci against the flow to Seidenberg ahead to Ekinla in the seam. He's got Lucic alongside. Ekinla goes to the end boards. Ekinla physical presence and Ekinla pulled up a little short. Lucic tries to scrape the puck back past Alfredson. Second chance follows it to the high slot and there are four wings in the way. Ryan Lashoff skates it over the red line. Unsigned free agent. Lashoff whacks the puck off the end boards. Krejci back to McQuaid. D to Tory Krug. Right up the middle for Lucic. Krug having scanned the front of the goal and knowing there were no Red Wings there. Braun with a big hit on the end boards, knocking Quincy off balance. McQuaid holds the puck and throws it around. Here's Quincy again. Kindle. Marchand unloads on Quincy. Franzen takes the hit to move the pass to Weiss. He's got Abdelkader on the right. Weiss's pass deflects. Kelly on the check against Abdelkader so he couldn't get comfortable with it. And Marchand slides it ahead to Caron. He tosses the backhand into DeKaiser's corner. DeKaiser turns it back looking for some help from Weiss who throws it up the half boards. Quincy's long pass center circle to Kaiser. He turns and looks for Weiss on the diagonal. Elects to go cross corner with the dump and Detroit changes.
Yeah, second time we've seen Detroit fly the zone. Even when they've been under pressure, we saw Zetterberg earlier in this period and then that time Abdelkader.
Wonder if they might have picked up something that Colorado was doing with some success against the Bruins. Erickson one hands the puck over. Glenn Denning the long pass. 2-2 on the go, which is the only way he plays. turns. His goalie's got a little speed, but the pass offline. Lashoff intercepts the shot off the glass, going wide on the blocker side. Krug under pressure. Strong stick from Miller. Thornton lobs it center circle. It bounces past Paye, and Kindle picks it up. Tremendous tempo now. A stuttering start to this game, but both teams have picked it up a few notches. Krug threads the needle to Paye, closes, goes back to the goal on the back end. He's got Campbell in the circle, brings it back to Chara. His blast, knocked down in front. Campbell one-handing it. Thornton in a real physical battle as he got behind Lashoff. Paye goes right through the puck, and Kindle carries out.
Now, all that pressure right there resulted in Krug making a great pass from wing to wing, hard to catch Lashoff trying to make a steal in the neutral zone. And it got all the way to Paye.
Kindle regroups, giving it back to Cronwall. Zetterberg coming deep as he starts his rush up the left side. And he receives the puck on the fly, tosses it out of the right for Bertuzzi playing on his off wing. Chara bangs him and the puck goes loose. Bertuzzi loves to mix it up. Datsyuk looking middle, but Boychuk knocking the puck off Zetterberg's blade. Riley Smith. Datsyuk there helping out Zetterberg. Smith tries again off Datsyuk and it trickles through to Bergeron, but the puck won't cooperate. Datsyuk with a quick turn into the Boston zone. Chara plays the body. Datsyuk goes around and sends it across. Zetterberg scores! The puck seems to do magical things for these two guys, and after a while you discover it's not the puck, it's the guys.
Well, they take advantage of a bad break for the Bruins. Smith actually completed his pass to Bergeron in the neutral zone, but the puck just would not lay flat. And that's an unforced turnover, but there is back pressure. Datsyuk is where he's supposed to be. And this is almost a non-move to get around Chara, which is the amazing thing about Datsyuk. He just lays that puck in a vulnerable area against a guy like Chara because of the length of his stick, the length of his reach. If you can get that puck in by his feet where you can't get it, where you can't get at it if you're Chara with the blade of your stick, and you continue to skate, continue a certain level of speed in that one-on-one, you can self-pass around Chara, and then that backhand pass had eyes, and the puck actually surprised. Once it got into Boychuk's dive, I think it surprised Riley Smith that the puck actually was coming across, and he didn't react, and it gets all the way to Zetterberg, and Zetterberg, quick release, and from a tough angle.
So TD Garden quiet as the Wings score the first goal of this one. Barkowski swings the puck over to Lucic. He gives it back to Barkowski under pressure from Alfredson. Lucic, the long reach stick handling. Let's Krejci take the puck into the zone. Seidenberg's one-timer and a glove stop by Gustafsson. The Bruins trying to answer right away, but Gustafsson turning away Seidenberg. Zetterberg has his fifth of the year.
1-0, you score. Turnover in the neutral zone, unforced. Bad bounce for Patrice Bergeron, but it's Pavel Datsyuk that really does the magic. And he's able to slide that puck underneath the stick in the on Zdeno Chara. That's a vulnerable spot when you're a big guy, Jack, with a long reach. You can nullify one-on-ones before the guy even gets within 10 feet of you with his reach. But if he does get close enough to you, you can put that puck close into the feet. It gives you a chance. Yep. And when you have the skill set of a Pavel Datsyuk, good things can happen.
Just astounding skill level. And that Zetterberg was there to make himself available in case Datsyuk could pull it off and bury it with little time and even less of an angle. Speaks to what everybody reveres when they talk about the Detroit Red Wings. You better bring your A game and then maybe some more.
But even though he gets around Chara in that situation, he's still at a difficult angle to score a goal. He's on his backhand. Chara's going to recover in time. Datsyuk will not have a lane to that near post. And Boychuk's coming across. You still think you're in pretty good shape.
Lashoff gets one through a screen just past the glove side post. Drew Miller on the far side. Kelly gives him a pretty good bump. Glendening bangs Seidenberg. Kelly hacks it out to center. 2-2. Looks for the quick re-entry. Miller absorbs the Seidenberg hit. Puck on edges. Barkowski whips it around to Thornton. He chips past 2-2 out to center, but Detroit has possession. And this is where the Red Wings are comfortable. Glendening accepts Kindle's long pass up ice. Tries to angle inside on Seidenberg to make sure he keeps the free hand unattached. Krug's pass a little too far forward, so Cronwall takes it, caroms it off the corner board. Seidenberg, one touch to Krug. Now Thornton swings it over to Paye, off his stick to Campbell. Campbell gives to Paye, drops off to Campbell. Campbell's long shot turned away to the corner by Gustafson, who did a good job of keeping the rebound from getting into a dangerous area. Campbell the steal at the line, and the reach from Weiss denies Paye, who had a little bit of space in the slot. Campbell, Boychuk back to Chara. He draws Abdelkader off Bergeron's backhand. Now Smith sends the puck in deep. Cronwall after it with Louis Erickson in pursuit. Erickson tips it away from Weiss. Weiss muscles it up the kick plate. Smith there to limit his space, and Bergeron keeps it alive. Bergeron takes the pass from Erickson down deep. Smith swings out of the corner. Boychuk back paddles toward the middle of the line. Krug intentionally wide, doesn't get the bounce he wants, but it comes around to the near corner. Boychuk strike scores! Johnny Boychuk! A rocket through a cloud, and it's all tied 1-1.
This puck definitely changed direction, whether it changed on its own on the shot by Boychuk or whether Louis Erickson gets a piece of it. We'll get a look on the replay. What a shift. Hard working, puck possession. Simplistic. I think Louis Erickson's going to get credit for this goal. Might have caught him on the shin pad if it didn't get a piece of his stick. But once again, the Bruins using point shots effectively to create offense, but it starts with battles along the wall, laying pucks in areas where you have an opportunity to get it back, and moving your defense up. A nice tight gap between forward and D in the offensive zone allows the Bruins to tie this hockey game.
Minutes and 18 seconds after Detroit scores the first goal, the Bruins answer, and it did indeed go off Erickson's leg. Datsyuk stick handling, gives it back to DeKaiser. The wrist shot pops out of Rask's glove. McQuaid off the corner glass. Krejci swings the puck to Chara. Banks it ahead, looking for a Ginla. Gustafson off the corner glass. It rattles off Franzen's body. Krejci and Datsyuk. Now Lucic in front of the penalty bench. Back to McQuaid, over to Chara. Chara, through traffic, it bounces behind Lucic's head, which is where Don Drysdale used to throw to Frank Robinson.
Ball scored by number 21, Louis Erickson.
Up the glass. I thought you'd use a Cardinal as a target, given the fact the Dodgers are playing St. Louis.
Yeah. Had to go vintage, though.
Time for the goal, 14.
Cross ice pass, Alfredson can't control it. Ginla pokes it away. Here's Marchand. Marchand working quickly to the corner. Ginla sets the edges, throws the shoulder in. Marchand brings it back to Seidenberg along the line to Barkowski. Chris it toward goal. Penalty coming here as Caron pursues the puck in the corner. Lashoff working him over. Rask makes his break to the Boston bench. Barkowski goes right down the slot, brings it on to Seidenberg. Extra skater is on in the person of Patrice Bergeron, who has the puck now. Bergeron stick handles around Alfredson, folds it, sends it through towards Seidenberg, tops it over to Barkowski in front for Caron on the doorstep, and he tips it wide. Bruins with some quality extra man time here. Bergeron's pass off Marchand's skate, possession for Anderson, and an interference call coming here. Louis Erickson has his second in a couple of games, and the Bruins will try to take the lead.
Bruins go on the power play. The power play was instrumental in the first meeting between these two clubs. Milan Lucic using that high triangle for puck possession play. The bomb by Krug at the point as he moves closer to the goal. Puts it Ano Char directly in front. He had an option to maybe slide it across to Ginla for the one-timer. And then a heads-up play by David Krejci to force Datsyuk's hands to get a little help from Milan Lucic. And then again, Krug, a bullet pass as he attacked the net in stride, found Char in front of the net. Backhand roof.
Lucic to Krug. The one-timer of Ginla. Gustafson down and out for a moment. Krug makes a nice stop, Bork-like even at the point. Extending and getting the blade of the stick down to catch the puck. Ginla in the corner, bangs it off the kick plate. Erickson turns and skitters it all the way down to Rask. David Krejci carries it out. He's got Krug racing up the left side, tosses the saucer pass to Ginla. Ginla holds at the half boards, back to Krejci with Glendening chasing. Glendening played more than 3 minutes shorthanded against the Flyers in his NHL debut. There's 43% of his ice time total in the game. Chara on the little backhand at the post. Chara winning another board battle, gets it past to Kaiser, all the way back to Krejci. Krug holds and draws Drew Miller. Krejci against Glenn Denning. And Kindler trying to force the pass through. And to Kaiser deflected it.
The two-on-one was there. McGinley was trying to use Chara as that two-on-one. Detroit trying to be aggressive on the PK and attack the Bruins anytime they move the puck towards the wall. The two-on-one was created, but unfortunately for McGinley, that pass deflected.
Corey Krug was hopping up on the dasher, and the attempt to dump it in by Detroit hit him in the leg. That's the reason for the stoppage.
Yeah, the Bruins like to get that puck to Iginla. We showed you the power play goal that Krug scored last time. We had the option, very similar. Gets into that shooting area there. This time he opts to find Iginla for the one time over by the faceoff dot. Gustafson went down, Jack. I didn't know if the Bruins were going to get caught with an interference, goaltend interference penalty on Zdeno Chara, but he kind of went down on his own.
Do that from time to time in Toronto also. Source of a few smiles. Anderson gets the puck out of the defensive zone for Detroit. Cronwall takes a hot puck on the backhand and clears it the length of the ring. That'll kill off Kindle's penalty. Zero shots on goal for the Bruins with the man advantage. Seidenberg chipping it up the boards. Perron to Marchand. He's got Kelly middle. Marchand shields the puck. Alfredson stacks him up. Marchand finds Kelly, who's coming near. Lash off patiently ahead to Datsyuk. He's got Zetterberg on the far side. Datsyuk to Zetterberg to quick release and a save by Rask. He quickly punches it out to Jordan Perron. Perron, the self pass off the glass. Can't get through Quincy. And Kindle takes it back to his own goal. Datsyuk swings to the right. Alfredson's in the middle of the ice. Zetterberg behind Alfredson. Datsyuk getting ridden off on Thornton's check. It's a good matchup right now for Detroit. Campbell stick handling, banks it off the boards and gets it out. Paille almost deflected Lashoff's pass into a playable area. Campbell coming on in support. The Bruins keep the puck in Detroit's end. Now the wings will change out, and the Campbell line does more than well enough against the likes of Datsyuk and Zetterberg. Kindle ahead for Weiss. Weiss swings it to the left. He's got Abdelkader behind the drive, in and out of Rask's glove side. Weiss brings it back to Eriksson. Eriksson backs the pass around the corner past Franzen. Lucic can't control the puck. Cronwall comes off the wall, tosses the saucer pass to Weiss, and Lucic is right in his face. Wing to wing to Ginlu, sets up good body position, then goes wing to wing to Krejci. Krejci to Lucic. Had he been a right shot, that would have been a one-timer, but he isn't. Cronwall brings it across. We're just moments away from Bill Schmidt joining the boys for an intermission interview. I'd like to say it could have been too many men on the ice. Nice little dance step, though. Tuukka Rask turns the puck to the corner, and the siren sounds. So the Bruins come from behind to send the teams to the rooms, tied 1-1 after one.
Well, you can expect more from Detroit today than you did last time. We certainly got that in the first period. Datsyuk and Zetterberg continue to create. No matter who they play against, they can be highly effective. But you got to like the way the Bruins picked up their game. They got a little boost from the tying goal after deflection by Eriksson, but they had more of a forecheck in the second half of that period.
Shots 9-9 in the first period. We got a good one going, Dale.
Into the Xfinity HD zone. Yesterday's double come from behind wins for the Red Sox and Patriots has lit a fire in this city that has carried over into the Bruins locker room. While Coach Claude Julien was at last night's game at Fenway for the Red Sox, Milan Lucic was at home watching the game, but he said he had an experience unlike any other when David Ortiz hit his game-tying grand slam.
I think it was like the first time that I've ever kind of like, you know, jumped out of my couch and cheered for something in a long, long time. But yeah, it was a great day of New England sports watching.
I'll tell you one thing: if the Bruins are down a couple with a few minutes to go, nobody's leaving this building today. Jamie in the Xfinity High Def Zone, brought to you by the Xfinity Triple Play TV, Internet, and Voice.
In a moment, you'll get a look at the first period summary brought to you by your New England Ford dealers. And Brick, after a bit of a herky-jerky start, that was a really entertaining first period. Both teams found their skating rhythm. We had interesting attacks from both sides.
Yeah, they both try to play to their strengths. And even though they're different in style, it's all about puck protection and puck possession. And that's what we expected the first time these two teams played, understanding that it was their game at four nights, back-to-back, and overtime in Carolina the day before. Maybe not just the energy the Red Wings wanted to bring to the game, but they're bringing it today. Two real good teams.
Datsyuk, Zetterberg, and Bertuzzi against the Bergeron line with Erickson, the goal scorer, and Riley Smith, who has been credited with an assist in his third consecutive game. Quincy bats the puck around. Bergeron extends to Smith. The wrist shot handcuffs Gustafson, but he puts the glove down on Helene St. James. Red Wings reporter is reporting that Jimmy Howard's late scratch was because of a bruised glove hand. Howard is now on the bench for Detroit, and there he is. Kind of bandaged up. Didn't know he was a lefty.
Four-letter word for... Oh, no, he's sorry. He's cracking something.
Or is he? It's like those bullpen games. Do something to look busy. Chris Kelly over to Dennis Seidenberg up into the neutral zone. Jordan Caron with some sting on it to Marchand. Marchand as Alfredson and Erickson collide down in the corner. Barkowski pinching in against Anderson. Marchand looks for the wraparound, brings it around the perimeter to Seidenberg, along the line to Barkowski. Barkowski fires it off of Anderson and into the protective netting, the faceoff in the Bruins attacking zone.
Marchand getting the attention of a number of wings. He's bringing a little bit of an edge to his game today, getting in on the forecheck, using his speed. Took that wing-to-wing opportunity through the neutral zone to get some speed through center ice with his line mates. And then as Caron battles down low, he's there for support, and he's chirping.
Well, that's his game, isn't it? And if you take his first period ice time and multiply it by three, it actually comes out ahead of his early season average time on ice per game. Well, Julian sending a message not only to Marchand but the rest of the team. Nobody's job is etched in stone. Adam McQuaid back after the puck, taps it around with Steven Weiss right on it. Krejci comes in, gives Weiss a bump. Now Franzen, who can create a little bit of space, does so, and Weiss emerges with the puck. Weiss tosses to Erickson. His high drive goes off the glass. Weiss to the corner, working against Lucic, who pokes the puck away. Now here's Krejci with a hop in his step, working straight towards Cronwell. Krejci pulls up, wrists it into the corner. Franzen riding Lucic, who turns away from that contact. Back to Seidenberg, the tip from Krejci, and it goes off the high glass behind Gustafson. Now Krejci takes a Ginla's cycle through the corner. Holds off Cronwell, but Weiss taps it away. Krejci gets it back. Seidenberg moving to set up the screen, goes intentionally wide. Krug had his stick locked down on Abdelkader's back check. Now Franzen flips the puck end over end into the slot. Abdelkader chasing against Seidenberg, who takes the hit to move it to Paille. Jakob Kindle forward to the red line, guns it around. Seidenberg with Glendening on the chase. Krug, the long diagonal tape to tape to Thornton. Thornton gets to the red line softly up the boards. Paille chasing into the corner. 2-2 looking to back into Paille. Puck comes loose, but Glendening left his stick behind. Campbell working against the stickless Glendening. Thornton, Glendening's stick actually broke, and he's stuck out on the long change, but the Bruins can't keep the puck in the attacking zone to take advantage of their numbers. Adam McQuaid up to the center dot. Bounces it off the boards. Gustafson maneuvers the puck through the driftwood. Now it's Datsyuk circling back. He winds it up out of his own zone. Past Riley Smith through the center circle. Barkowski and Datsyuk. Barkowski sends it around. Zetterberg seals it off. Centering pass. Too high and hot for Bertuzzi to handle. Cronwall right on Rask with Bertuzzi screening. Quincy on the far side. Hammers it around. Detroit using the full width of the ice here. Zetterberg turns off the boards, goes past Datsyuk. Now gives it to him. Datsyuk just waited for the flow to go right on by, but his return pass intercepted by Eriksson. Now Bergeron with a break. Can't get the shot off. Datsyuk, stick check from behind. Chara pitches down to the half board. Datsyuk spins around and takes the hit from Chara to move it to Zetterberg. Now Quincy with a quick pivot against Lucic through the seam. Bertuzzi couldn't get past Boychuk, and this is going to be icing.
Take your game viewing experience to a whole new level with Garden Greats Sweet Rail Package. Watch the game with a Bruins legend and score seating for up to 24 guests, all-inclusive food and beverage, never before offered behind-the-scenes access and more. Visit bostonbruins.com/gardengreats or call 617-624-1VIP.
Looks as if Mike Babcock's going to use a timeout here. You know, Detroit is one of only two teams in the NHL without a fighting major so far this year. And you've said many times, Brick, that there are a lot of different ways to show toughness. But one of the reasons that the Detroit Red Wings don't get in a lot of fights is that they play the game the right way. There isn't cheap shot stuff going on. There isn't anything going on behind the play.
No, and they have some guys that will answer the bell if necessary when a message needs to be delivered or responded to, especially if there's liberties taken with guys like Datsyuk and or Zetterberg, etc. But you're right. That's been one of the hallmarks of this franchise is that sure they had toughness. You know, we certainly discussed that on the Instigators the other night, talking about different guys that wore this Red Wings uniform that were tough guys that would drop the gloves no problem. But the game's evolving, and if you can stay ahead of that evolvement, stay ahead of the curve, you're going to be a competitive team, and their record of being in the playoffs and Stanley Cup championships needs no further explanation.
Zetterberg taps it away from Boychuk. He looks over his shoulder for Bertuzzi closing. Boychuk off the end boards. Chara risks the puck to a Gidlin, a touch pass. Lucic moving it around. Anderson gives it on the right to Krejci. To a Gidlin, the drive save. Juicy rebound. And Bertuzzi just skies it off the glass. Triangles all over the place, and the Bruins hitting take-to-take passes. Now Dan Cleary. Boychuk stands him up and the puck goes adrift. Gidlin off the boards and all the way in behind Gustavs.
Turning defense in an offense, Jack. That started with a real good effort by Johnny Boychuk defensively to get a good angle on Zetterberg and ride him off the puck. Led to a quality breakout and then the one-time chance for Gidlin.
Big bounce off the corner boards. Hanson one hands it in behind Rask. Seidenberg rides the dasher. Perron knocking it down. Marchand, the nice pass back to Seidenberg. He's got Kelly breaking ahead. Couldn't thread the needle as Cleary got his legs in the way. Marchand with speed over the line. The shot saved. Gustavsson bounces around. Kelly fires in and it flutters across the slot. Marchand drops the shoulder. Seidenberg keeps the puck inside the zone. Barkowski holding at the boards. Throws it toward goal with Perron screening and jamming against Kindle. Now it's Marchand coming off the corner boards. Weiss on his back. Seidenberg strokes the backhand around. Perron keeps the rhythm going, finds Marchand in a seam. Alfredson pokes him. Seidenberg, the good effort to get it to Barkowski. Cross ice, Marchand holds the snapshot. All the way through, a lot of traffic in front of Gustavsson. Perron putting the effort to it. Kindle off glass, and Marchand keeps the Red Wings pinned in their own end. The Bruins will try to change out and keep this tired bunch of wings on the ice. Seidenberg working down to the corner. Alfredson kicks it loose, gets it forward to Weiss. Weiss to Kindle into the Boston zone, and the Red Wings happy to get off the hook there.
Great shift again by Marchand. Totally committed, focused, winning battles, getting the loose pucks, making plays.
Abdelkader, the self-pass, and he picks it up behind Kelly. Kelly gets back in the play with the second effort. Perron to Kelly, rattles it off Franzen's legs. Now Eriksson takes the pass back from Glendening. And the return from Cronwall. Franzen gains the line with Abdelkader going toward goal. Haye putting the body on against Franzen. Thornton to McQuaid. Proved a quick spin, and he banks it to Haye. Paye has Campbell on the far right. Coxon fires. Glove save. A little juggle. And the grab from Gustavsson. 13:34 to go. Second period. Very entertaining matinee between two of the original six.
Johnny Boychuk, Bruins defense, takes a real good angle against a very dangerous offensive talent Henrik Zetterberg rides him off the play, and it leads to the Bruins with a 3-on-2 or 3-on-3, depending on how you want to look at it. Opportunity at the opposite end. It was a quality breakout. Get the puck in the hands of the playmaker, David Krejci. Sets up a Ginla for his 15th shot of the season. A one-timer with a little bit of traffic. Gustafson makes a big-time stop.
Shots in 13 and a half periods. That's a pretty good rate. Bergeron wins it from Datsyuk. Louis Erickson off a wing and up out of play. If you text 536-536, you'll see the Patrice Bergeron tutorial on faceoffs. From the guy who led the National Hockey League in faceoffs last year. Bergeron head-to-head with Datsyuk in October. They'll be head-to-head in February at the Olympics. And who knows? Maybe in May in a division final playoff series. Bergeron just passed Riley Smith's forehand. No icing. And it flies back. Smith puts the body on him. Quincy feeds it quickly out to Datsyuk. He dumps the puck off the boards, and Bergeron's all the way back to pick it up. Looks for Erickson. Datsyuk with a good read. Getting a clinic on how to play center from these two guys today. Erickson scrapes the backhand around to Boychuk. Zetterberg cowboys right over the sliding puck. No icing ruled. Cromwell back around for Cleary. Aginla pinches down and steals the puck. Aginla going back of the goal. Erickson wraps him up. Back Krejci wrists it back to Krug. Krug to Lucic to Krug. The shot knocked down in front of Aginla in traffic. Krug's shot again. A save by Gustafson as he reached down with the inside of the blocker. Krug to Aginla. Holds. Gets Cromwell to move. Off Cronwell's skates. Good defensive. Getting in position by Nicholas Cronwell. Krug chases it back to Lucic, who had rotated to the point. The activeness of the Bruins defenseman really providing a different dimension. Lucic can't get the puck through Cronwell, who's made three good defensive plays. This one almost comes off Erickson and finds the five hole, but Gustafson puts the glove down on it.
Well, after David Krejci gets his puck back to the left point, Torrey Krug. Impressive little give and go. That subtle little fake as if he's going to let a wrist shot go. He straightens up Alfredson, finds Lucic, and then steps around the Detroit Red Wing and makes himself available. And all the activity in front of the net, get a good look at it from the overhead. Red Wing players just diving in front of that crease, trying to help out their goaltender, who was all over the place, trying to track that puck. Great pressure again by the Krejci line.
Kelly wins the draw, but good work from Abdelkader, keeping Caron from taking possession. Franzen hits the Jets down the wing. Seidenberg recovers just in time. Centering pass, Weiss scores! Franzen found a seam, and Steven Weiss picks the corner. It's 2-1 Wings.
And this is what Detroit can do. They can stop momentum by scoring a goal on what appears to be a nothing play. Seidenberg loses an edge a little bit in center ice. That allows Franzen to get to this puck. But the Bruins have enough bodies back. It's just a breakdown in coverage. Marchand a little late, sagging back on that weak side to help out in the slot. And Weiss takes that nice little feed from Franzen. And as Tuukka Rask moves out, an aggressive move. A little vulnerable to that blocker side. Weiss finishes.
It's the first time that Rask has allowed two goals in a game this season. Lashoff locking down against Caron. Rask has to make a stop from Lashoff's wrist shot. Marchand gets the legs moving. Maneuvers around 2-2. Barkowski carries all the way to the slot. The shot caroms off a leg and goes wide. Kelly taps it loose. Marchand draws four. Caron's shot blocked, never gets through.
And number 23,
Lynn Denning out of the left side.
8 minutes, 21 seconds.
Looks for the return feed.
Second goal of the season.
Drew Miller tossed it toward middle. Kelly cross ice. Quincy ends up tapping it right to Chara, who takes the right wing position on the rush.
Chara with a huge reach goes for the wraparound, but Gustafson saw it coming and had the blocker down. Quincy skates it over the spoked B. Wiggles the puck toward the corner. Bertuzzi gets the shoulder underneath Chara and gets leverage. Chara tries to cave in Bertuzzi and knocks his helmet off. Bergeron taps it around through the corner. Quincy angles it off his skates. Datsyuk, great hands to DeKaiser. Bergeron on the shot, block back to Datsyuk. And Datsyuk gains the line, works right side, leg saved by Tuukka Rask. Bertuzzi throws the puck forward up the slot. I was watching Bergeron go to the bench. And he appears to be none too much the worse for wear.
And this is where you want to keep your composure for the Boston Bruins. You know Detroit scored 3 power play goals in their last outing. Not the time to get an undisciplined penalty. Momentum critical right now in this hockey game.
The crowd senses it, chanting, "Let's go Bruins," at TD Garden. Boychuk with the extension to poke the puck loose. Here's Krejci with Ekinla behind him and Lucic going down the slot. Ekinla holds the shot, saved by Gustafson. 30-foot rebound, and Alfredson turns it into transition. Alfredson swoops in, crisscrossing with Cronwell. Cronwell misfires on the one-timer off Anderson's feet. Now it's Alfredson in front. Cleary scores! Dan Cleary on a one-timer from close range. 2 goals in a minute and 2 seconds, or rather about 3 minutes, excuse me. And Detroit jumps on top 3-1.
Yeah, Detroit feeling it right now. Nice rotation in the offensive zone. They've activated their D on the attack. And even though they don't complete that one-timer over towards Cronwall, they keep the play alive below the goal line. And Cleary's able to find a seam right in front of the net. Nice little backhand feed. But again, black jerseys all around the slot area, but not close enough, but not strong enough in coverage. And Cleary finds that seam. Forehand, a one-timer on the backhand feed from behind the net by Alfredson.
Bruins Rewind is coming up during our next break, so we'll be away for just 30 seconds. Stay with us through that. That's coming up shortly. Campbell looking for a big hit against Erickson, but he didn't get much of it. Out front, comes cross ice to Cronwell. Cronwell up to the red line, and he snaps the puck past Rask all the way around to McQuaid's corner. Abdelkader puts the body on him. Campbell comes over to pick up the puck. The pass behind Thornton. Detroit takes possession right back. Lashoff having a battle from both Thornton and Campbell. The puck's behind them both. Franzen comes over to put his body on Campbell. Thornton comes in right in front of the Detroit bench. Campbell chops the puck out of the skates and he finds Krug. Krug with a couple of steps to the middle, opening up a seam. Paye for Krug. The redirection on the backhand goes past the post on the glove side. Krug tough as nails in the corner, banging around with Lashoff, and a cross check called here.
I think it's going to be on Franzen.
The Bruins answering with some physical play, and they will go on the power play when the game resumes, down 3-1.
Time now for the Berkshire Bank exciting rewind. We're going to rewind. A couple days ago in Columbus, the Bruins in a penalty killing situation, and Jerome Iginla taking the draw. He's out there with David Krejci, and his stick breaks immediately on the faceoff, and now he's in a little bit of trouble because he has to kill this penalty. But what he wants to do is keep some kind of lane with any attempted shot high on the umbrella. And even without a stick, you can stand in the line of the shot and discourage the defenseman from shooting the puck on the power play, and he does all of that. Now, you also got to get a little help down low. It's almost in a power-eye situation with David Krejci. Krejci reading off Iginla. When Iginla tries to stay in the shooting lane, now David Krejci has to react, maybe more side to side because he has a stick with good stick position. And then Iginla, there's just no give in when you're killing a penalty. Even without a stick, he recognizes that puck's up for grabs. He's able to get inside position on Johansson, make contact with Tootin, and force that puck into the neutral zone. Now he has an opportunity to go get his stick. The Bruins make sure that that stick is at the furthest point of the bench, so you minimize the time it requires to go get it. And now, even though this is a shot that Bobrovsky probably should save, it is a bomb by Chris Kelly, but it was Jerome Iginla that actually figures in on the goal with that back diagonal pass in center ice.
Bruins did not get off a shot despite having the puck in the Detroit zone for 1:09 of the 2 minutes of their first power play this afternoon.
And you were right, Jackie. It was Lashoff for the cross check in the box, not Franz. And Bruins, an opportunity now, finding themselves down a pair of goals to have their power play be productive.
It's the first time they've had a power play in this brief season. Went down by two. Not just how many you score, but when you score them. Cronwall off the skates of Krejci, and it ricochets wildly around the bench area. So the face-off at the center dot. Why every little bit of effort is worth it, because that prevents the Bruins from having to go back and bring the puck all the way the length of the ice. Of course, Anderson then wins the face-off.
I don't think Krejci even got a stick down.
Didn't even contest it. So this is obviously what Krejci wanted. To have a full 200-foot view. Krejci softly toward the corner. Krug races in there against Erickson. Cronwall gets a stick on it, but McGinley gets it back to Krejci. Tosses the pass to Krug, who flattens the puck and finds Krejci. He's got Lucic on the far side, McGinley on the near side. That one gets between McGinley's stick and his skates. Chara back to Krejci, who has to turn the stick for the pass. Krug fires with Chara on the tip, and it goes wide. Krejci active, then saucers it to Krug. Lucic out high. With the other option, Lucic brings it to Krejci, but the puck pops over his stick. Krejci to Lucic. Again, good movement from McGinley. Here's Krug closing for McGinley, looking for the high slot tip. Doesn't connect. Krejci. Krug drawing clearing. Krejci to Lucic to blast. Cronwall on the brave block. Lucic comes off the half boards, moves past Krug, Ginla's drive, and Gustafsson lunges out for the save. The wings clear.
I love everything that the Bruins are doing with that power play, their movement, puck possession, when you know one of the defensemen is being forced. Lucic gets himself open. When they work that play, Krejci to Krug, Krug back to Krejci. Would like to see Milan Lucic come a little closer so that one timer doesn't take forever to happen.
Louis Erickson to Boychuk underneath Seidenberg's forehand. He chips it down the wall. Bergeron to Boychuk, fakes the shot. Drew Miller out there to contest it. The pass a little offline, and Glendening gets there before Seidenberg can. Lashoff's out of the box. One shot on goal during the power play, but a much better look from the Bruins. Boychuk loses his stick, so mashes Miller against the end boards to try to make him stay put. And the puck deflects out of play with 6:19 to go in the second. Minute 45 in the zone, and some much better looks for the Bruins.
No, they were doing exactly what they wanted to do in terms of possession. They were looking for those redirect shots when the puck was shot from the point, whether it was Krug or Krejci, no matter who it was that was working for that shot. But that pet possession play. This is the attempt for Ginla. Krug tried one earlier for Chara that just missed.
Caron. Bronson with the pressure, angling him off. Abdelkader flicks the puck into Seidenberg's corner. Seidenberg knocks Abdelkader a little bit off balance. Weiss chases in the corner, brings it back. A long shot from Lashoff and a leg save by Rask. Weiss flips forward to Kindle. He turns and fires. It's off the back of Seidenberg's leg. Marchand skates through the defensive block back to Boychuk. Now Kelly after the puck in the center zone, but Weiss rolls it in. Boychuk has Riley Smith, elects to go straight ahead to Louis Erickson. Erickson past Bergeron. Quincy to DeKeyser. Erickson's in there wreaking a little havoc. Datsyuk tries to calm things down for Detroit. Bertuzzi with the reach, and he comes cross ice for Zetterberg. Zetterberg works the angle on Chara, runs out of real estate, and Bergeron bangs the puck back to center. DeKeyser to Datsyuk. DeKeyser carries to the red line. Now it's Quincy. The long wrist shot, an easy glove stop for Rask, but he'll have to take the faceoff with Zetterberg in his grill. 5:05 to go in the second period. Steven Weiss put the Wings on top, and Dan Cleary gave them an insurance margin.
At TD Garden for Columbus Day Hockey, it's been a pretty unbelievable weekend for Boston sports. Claude Julien said he listened to the end of the Patriots game in the car on the way to watch the Red Sox game in person at Fenway last night. And Coach said he likes to think the Bruins started this trend back with their Game 7 win over Toronto. Which one of those most come-from-behind wins is the most improbable. Text your vote A, B, or C to 536-536. We will track the results all throughout the day here on NESN. Remember, message and data rates may apply.
Of course, the disclaimer there is that we are talking about the target of the target audience for Bruins fans right now. May not be the most objective crowd out there, but they were all remarkable in their own way. Great day in sports yesterday, and the Bruins hope to add to that with what would be a pretty nice comeback victory, currently trailing Detroit by two. Trouble from Daniel Alfredson, who sends it in front. Only black sweaters there. Adam McQuaid rattles it off a couple of skates. Thornton nudges it along. Pass Lash off 2-on-1 with Paille. Thornton's driving, a save by Gustafson. Long angled rebound. And Zetterberg will give chase. Rask comes out of his goal. Spins it right across the gaping mouth of the net. Zetterberg steals from Seidenberg on the far side. Campbell backhand off the boards to center. Quincy bounces it in behind the Boston goal.
Yeah, Thornton just couldn't generate enough speed and get enough of an angle to really attack Gustafson and really create a two-on-one. And the minute he realizes that, his best option is to take a shot and maybe generate a rebound on that far side.
Datsyuk making a lot of contact with Krug right in front of the penalty bench, the reason for the crowd's reaction. Lucic with the steal against Kyle Quincy. Lucic gets it to Ginla. Ginla, I don't know if he was going intentionally wide looking for a bouncer, if he just misfired off the heel of the stick.
No, he was trying to get that puck towards David Krejci for some kind of redirect.
Chara absorbs the Bertuzzi hit. Boychuk with Datsyuk in his face. Erickson takes the puck away. He goes cross ice. Both teams really have used the full 85-foot width today. Hasn't been a whole lot of jamming it up the middle, even when it isn't there. They'll find the space. Perron taps the puck back to center. Weiss with an eye over his shoulder to make sure the play's onside. Boychuk sees Abdelkader's hit coming. Abdelkader creates something, throws it in front. Caron perfectly positioned. He hoists the backhand into the Detroit bench. The faceoff will be in the Boston zone.
Tonight at 10, catch up with Adam Pellerin and Leah Hextall for NESN Sports Today, presented by People's United Bank. We'll have more on the Bruins and the latest on the Red Sox from Detroit, a complete recap of the Patriots' thrilling victory over the Saints. Check it all out tonight at 10.
If you're just hopping on over from some other channel location, welcome. It's the Bruins and Red Wings. Henrik Zetterberg got the scoring going in the first period with some magical handiwork from Pavel Datsyuk setting that up. The Bruins answered on a Louis Erickson goal, deflected in off his shin on a Johnny Boychuk drive about 3 minutes later. And then Detroit scored twice in 2 minutes and 20 seconds here in the second period to take this 3-1 lead. But on a weekend of comebacks, you know better than to tune out. Caron looking for Kelly. Jakub Kindle has Brian Lashoff on the left. Kindle off the boards with Abdelkader changing out. Bartkowski sees 2-2 skating through Rask's crease, feeds it out for Chris Kelly. Kelly works it up ice around Drew Miller. Bounces it in wide of Jonas Gustafsson. Gustafsson, a late starter. Here's an errant pass. Krug's blast into a lot of traffic. Now Seidenberg jumps down the boards. Glenn Denning tries to check him off the puck. Kelly comes in to find it. Backs it to the rotating Caron, the winger back in the defensive position when Seidenberg went forward. He dumps in the Bruins change out. A minute and a half to go in the second. Bergeron with Riley Smith going up the slot. Cross ice. Erickson to Krug. The backhand save. Rebound. Snow Angel from Gustafson. It's still loose. Bergeron trying to dig it loose from underneath his legs. And the Wings get the whistle.
Quick counterattack by Boston from the neutral zone. After some decent pressure by the Kelly line, the Krug chance coming off the bench. The Bruins get fresh bodies on the ice. That's a well-executed play. Bergeron, Erickson, Krug. That puck was loose. There was a second-chance opportunity there. Gustafson with the big body just trying to lay out. The puck was close to getting in behind him and across the line. And once again, Detroit doing everything they can to help their goaltender by just laying out as well in the blue paint.
Jackson wins the puck off the Bergeron draw. Bartkowski from the red line. DeKeyser can't get the puck past Louis Erickson. DeKeyser absorbs a Bergeron check and ices it. 1:07 to go in the second. Boston looking for a timely goal to get within one and give itself an emotional boost going into the room.
Yeah, Gustafson's been tough today. Yep. Even when the Bruins have some real good looks, he's had good body position. He's a big man. He's getting some help, some shot blocks, and Detroit's doing a pretty decent job of boxing out. And rebounds are there.
Quick on the Stephen Weiss goal. That's weird. The final minute, you said it's one of those that didn't look like there was much there, and then all of a sudden there was. We'll give the boys downstairs in the studio a chance to break it down in depth between periods. McKinlaw on the end boards, draws two in the corner, both DeKeyser and Alfredson, who's locked up. 40 seconds to go. Krug pulls the puck off the boards. One timer from Seidenberg, bouncing around the front, and Gustafson finds the rebound with the blocker hand. And now tempers flare a little bit as the Bruins battle for real estate, and the Wings want to protect it.
DeKeyser and David Krejci in a battle. Krejci trying to get inside position and get to that loose puck. Krug sliding that hard pass across. Good one timer by Seidenberg. This line's had some good looks today. There's your one-timer by Seidenberg. Knocked down off the leg of McKinla, I believe. And you can see that battle. The guys are trying to work over David Krejci. And, of course, Milan Lucic needing to get into that pile as well.
So we're going to have matching penalties, I believe, or at least coincidental. Two for roughing. And they'll send him straight to the room. DeKeyser and Krejci with just 30.8 seconds showing on the center ice clock. So it'll be a 4-on-4 situation into the third period, unless there's another
Detroit
penalty.
Penalty number 65, Danny DeKeyser of Boston. Penalty
Erickson drops the puck back to Cronwall. Marchand, Bergeron, Chara, and Boychuk. Against Zetterberg, Datsyuk, Erickson, and Cronwall. A whole lot of talent on the ice right now. I would imagine breaking the discussion on the Boston bench right now is get the next one. Can't score them two at a time, but make sure Detroit doesn't get the next one.
Yeah, that's what it's been over the last several minutes. Right now, with 14.5 to go, it's make sure it's no worse than 3-1. Let's win a face-off. Let's protect the puck here and gear up for the third.
Chara clicking into the final 10 seconds, keeping the puck away from Datsyuk, shielding it. Now Bergeron over the line, just 4 seconds to go as Gustafson guides the puck to the Zamboni doors. McGinley mucks there against Jonathan Erickson, and the siren sounds, the second period in the books, and after 40 minutes it is 3-1 Detroit.
Well, the Bruins certainly have had their share of momentum swings in this hockey game in their favor, but Detroit, the Red Wings, showing that they have been more opportunistic than Boston, making more of their opportunities than the Bruins have been able to.
Dale, it was at about this point in the game, the last time these two teams met, that it seemed Detroit ran out of gas. Well, the tank is full today, and we got a good one going. Boston Bruins Hockey on Nesson is brought to you by Subaru of New England, by Amica Insurance, by Toyota's official website for deals, buyatoyota.com, by Kettle One, by your New England Audi dealers, and by TD Bank, America's most convenient bank. After 40 minutes, it's the Red Wings 3, the Bruins 1. Alongside Andy Brickley with Jamie Erdahl at ice level and our Nesson production crew, I'm Jack Edwards. Let's get a view from inside the room as moments ago, Brick talked to Bruins assistant Jeff Ward.
Jeff, anytime you give up a goal against, there's always a number of breakdowns. When you take a look at the replay, there's a lot of black and gold jerseys around that slot area. When you gave up a couple goals in that period, what needs to be better?
Well, I think we have to stop in the house. You know, they beat us back to the net a few times, and it's resulted in goals. And I think we've just, as much as we've done offensively, sometimes it's not what you make, it's what you leave. And we've left an opportunistic team with a few too many chances in our slot, beating us back to the net. And you don't want to give them those chances because they're going to cash them.
Well, you mentioned what you've been able to get done offensively in terms of pressure and opportunities. Where do you think Detroit is most vulnerable here this afternoon?
Well, I think we have to keep getting our D active. You know, every time we've gotten the D involved in the rush or the cycles, we've gotten good opportunities at the net. And it's a matter now of trying to work with the guys inside for those second and third whacks at it to get it by a big goaltender. So I think that's the key for us. Keep the defensemen active in the rush and in the cycles, and keep that offensive zone spread till the puck goes to the net, and then fill those rebound lanes.
Thanks a lot, Jeff. Good luck in the third period.
Thank you.
Great stuff there, Brick. And yes, when we've seen the Bruins defensemen go down the wings, go down the boards, get involved, we saw Krug with that tremendous shoulder fake to set up the give and go. Things get really exciting in the Boston attacking end.
Yeah, and you're going to have that mentality right from the puck drop here in the third period. This isn't wait till the 10-minute mark before you get really active. So Jeff Ward, what he's talking about is it has to be there for this entire 20 minutes. Detroit's too good, they're too deep, they're too strong defensively unless you activate, unless you're a 5-man attack, and that's what we'll be looking for here in the third.
Yeah, and it also is one of those situations where despite the zone time, where the Bruins have had the puck in the attacking zone 4.5 minutes more than Detroit has through two periods, which is a huge margin. It is what you leave behind. If Detroit doesn't leave anything behind, boy, they get their chances, they bury them.
No, and Jeff Woods used the same word we were using, and opportunistic is what Detroit has been this afternoon. You know, you take a look at those replays, Jack. You had five black and gold jerseys around the slot, yet Danny Cleary finds a seam in between everybody. You know, that can't happen if you're Boston. You need to be tighter. You need to be a little bit more committed, work a little bit harder to get inside position, both defensively and offensively. Talked about the opportunities the Bruins have had. Talked about second, third opportunities. Look at the shots blocked. If you look at the statistics, 13 blocked shots by Detroit. Boston's only had to have four.
Game summary brought to you by your New England Ford dealers. So the Bruins hope to find a few more lanes to goal. But Gustafson has offered a few rebounds. Here's Zetterberg working Chara's side. Backhand on Rask. Chara bangs the puck around into the corner. Riley Smith with the effort to get it past Erickson. Now Franzen on the back check against Bergeron, knocking the puck backward. Datsyuk, who had rotated back with his defenseman going forward. And Zetterberg carries out. Datsyuk kicks, but not to the stick. Kelly in a collision with Erickson in the neutral zone. Smith over the line. Kelly's shot and a save by Gustafson. Datsyuk stumbles a bit on the boards. And Erickson will wait for personnel to change out. Johan Franzen. The drop pass. Daniel Alfredsson carries into the Boston zone against Barkowski, who sticks it away and plays the body. Now puts the body on Alfredsson, who spins it off Barkowski's legs. Franzen in the corner against Seidenberg, who gives him the forearm shiver. Franzen holds him off, maintains possession of the puck, whips it through the slot. Alfredsson is first to it, beating Louis Erickson. Rattles off a couple of legs. Here's Franzen. Franzen pulls up, turns to the forehand. Seidenberg tries to work him over the quick pivot. Franzen is so strong, and he knocks Seidenberg backwards. You don't see that more than two or three times a season. Kelly on the poke check, and the puck goes the length of the ice.
Great battle between those two titans, really. Tremendous balance and strength and commitment. Franzen committed to the offensive opportunity. Seidenberg doing the job. Body on body.
Dan Cleary gets a piece of the puck. Wade lifts out the Gator stick. Krug patient to wait for the passing lane to Lucic. Lucic's pass bounces through to Krejci finally. Here's a Ginla on a bouncing puck. He and DeKeyser go shoulder to shoulder. Lucic, the diagonal, a little bit out of Torrey Krug's reach. Torrey Krug carries. It's in Krejci's skates. Krejci gets it past Drew Miller. Glendening to Cronwall. Erickson ahead to 2-2. Lucic with back pressure. 2-2, the quick release. Dale Arnold has a Toyota game break.
Fans, the Bruins in Tulsa.
Nesson Sports Today coming up tonight at 5:30 and 10 o'clock. Adam Peller and Leah Hextall have all the highlights, all the analysis. A remarkable day in Boston sports on Sunday, capped off late on Sunday night by the Red Sox win over the Detroit Tigers. Nesson Sports Today at 5:30 and 10, coming up later on. Jack?
Dale, thank you. Seidenberg and Franzen in a terrific battle, and they'll have another shift against one another, probably coming up in about a minute and a half. Riley Smith taking it back in the Boston zone. The Bruins have not had the lead today. Zetterberg on the check, knocks down Smith. That's up to Bertuzzi, spins the backhand deflection toward Rask. And there it was again. Everything seemed to be under control, and 4 seconds later, it was an emergency.
Detroit's got good sticks. Even when the Bruins have had possession today, they've had stick-on-stick contact, which has disrupted Bruins' passing, and they've created some turnovers as well by using good stick position.
Bergeron, Datsyuk, and Bergeron wins the faceoff cleanly. Boychuk to Char. Crosses out to Smith, who chops the puck forward, looking for Louis Erickson. It's in the linesman's legs. Smith to Boychuk, the defenseman activating. Fires it across, got the rebound that he desired. And the Wings have to send the puck the length of the rink. It won't make the goal line, so it's no ice.
Good example there of activating the D. That time, Johnny Boychuk up with the rush.
Just what Jeff Ward was talking about with it between the second and third period. The Bruins ice it here. Well, when those defensemen are on the move, good things are happening this afternoon for Boston.
Yeah, this is a tough icing call going against Boston, but you're right. Johnny Boychuk trying to jump up into the play. You have to do it with time. He can't get there too early. The initial rush was stymied at the offensive blue line for Boston, so they had to do a quick little regroup. But Johnny Boychuk was there, maybe a little bit too early because he had to reach back and get it.
Anderson pinballs the puck off a couple of skates, and it slides just wide of the club side post to Tuukka Rask. Chara gathers the puck, hoists it from the red line all the way in behind Gustafsson. It bounces right in front. Kindle shepherds the puck out of danger, but Caron steals it. Now the quick turn from Marchand. He fans on the centering pass looking for Caron, who had found himself a little bit of space high slot.
Well, it's Marchand that got in on the forecheck. Used his skate in the passing lane to disrupt the play. That's what deflected out over the net out to the slot area.
Caron to Krejci. He closes the shot off Cronwell's legs. And now Weiss wants to turn it into transition. Krejci with back pressure. Krug getting a stick on the puck. Weiss chips for Franzen. Franzen in front, but Lucic is there unopposed. Lucic circles back softly off the end boards. Krug goes D to D to McQuaid. McQuaid to Krejci. Lucic on the long diagonal with speed. Here's Aguila spooning the puck to the corner. He'll chase it himself. Goes in, gets past the Cronwall. Hip check, throws it off a couple of legs, and Gustafsson has to make a stick save. Penalty coming up against Cronwall here as Lucic has put the Bruins on a power play. Aguila turns toward net. Still loose. Aguila for Lucic. Krejci on the effort. It comes back to Seidenberg, and finally the referee rules possession amid the broken sticks and the pile of bodies.
You get the sense that Detroit had touched the puck somewhere in this scramble. At what point, though, do you touch it and you get credit for having some kind of possession? But it's a one-on-one battle. Cronwall and Lucic. Lucic trying to spin away. Enough stick work by Cronwall. Into the hands area where Lucic is trying to make a play with the puck. And there's a touch by Detroit. Boston, again, second, third opportunities. The mad scramble. Cronwall already had one shot that he blocked on this shift earlier. But again, the Red Wings desperate to try to get to that front of the net, top of the crease area, to disrupt any Bruins' chances at empty nets.
Detroit penalty, number 55, Cronwall.
Bartkowski trying to get around Cleary, and Cleary trips him. The Bruins will be 5-on-3 for a minute and 54 seconds, potentially. And here the game turns, one way or the other.
Pretty good move, lateral by Bartkowski after a face-off win in the offensive zone. Maybe somewhere during the sequence, if not right now, you use your timeout. Critical juncture in the hockey game. You want to make sure everybody's on the same page. Bruins will have an opportunity to talk things over. They're going to use their timeout right now.
So, Brick, this gives us an opportunity to talk about the 5-on-3 and how it differs from the 5-on-4. So often you've talked about the left shot on the right side or the right shot on the left side or both, and working high-low and the importance of ratcheting toward goal.
Well, you want to have one guy on the offside out high. So typically Char in that situation, the threat of the one-timer bomb from close range. The other defenseman or the other player out high can be a left shot as well. He's more the playmaker. He sets everything in motion when you're generating from high. But you want to transfer that puck high-low in order to get that triangle either inverted or in a very vulnerable position where you get a quality shot. But have a one-timer like a Gilbert on one side, have a real good puck guy in around that slot area in the front of the net, and then have a dangerous one-timer as the high guy as well. Those are three areas that you really look to as your weapons.
Bergeron got thrown out of the faceoff before the puck was dropped. Erickson, Quincy, and Dotson, the three skaters.
And have a pace to your 5-on-3. Don't settle into that stationary, very methodical. Have some pace and force Detroit to have to move.
And Cronwall in the box, the leading shorthanded time on ice player for the Red Wings. Rask on his belly to knock the puck down. Chara turning up with Louis Erickson flying up the left side. Gives to Krejci on the right. Bergeron already at the attacking line. Now back to Chara. Datsyuk out on him. Erickson all the way around for Krejci, who's the right shot on the left side. The left shot on the right side is Erickson. Here's Chara with the threat of the bomb. McGinley has a big shot as well. Now it's Krejci at the dot with Bergeron jamming in front. The Bruins looking for some tempo here. Chara to McGinley. The drive goes well wide. Chara with a big reach knocks it down to keep the puck in the attacking zone. Erickson rotating. Now McGinley setting up for the one-timer far side. Elects not to take it. Sends low for Krejci. Krejci has Bergeron in front. Chara out high. The one-timer save. Rebound Erickson corrals it. Couldn't get the shot off. McGinley's drive deflected on the way in. Datsyuk with control. And he backhands it the length of the ring.
The setup's good. Just going to move it a little bit quicker.
Rask to Chara to Erickson back into the attacking zone. Chara across to McGinley. Again, Krejci low on that side. Krejci to Bergeron in front. Krejci gets it loose. Chara's blast saved by Gustafsson and it rattles to the end boards. Erickson goes in hard. DeKeyser unable to clear past Bergeron. DeKeyser holding the puck, trying to bleed some clock. Erickson and Krejci getting there. Here's a Ginla shot. Save Gustafsson. Ginla to Chara. He cocks and goes intentionally wide, hoping Erickson can corral it. He does. To Chara to Ginla. The bomb, and that leaves a dent in the end glass. 20 seconds to go in the power play for Boston. Less than 15 in the 5-on-3. Krejci on the goal line. The saucer to Erickson. And Gustafsson reaching with the glove. Final few seconds of the 5-on-3. Krejci to Bergeron. Tries to jam it toward goal. It's 5-on-4. Three shots on the power play. Chara's backup drive goes wide. Erickson knocks it down off the end boards. It's back to 5-on-5. Cleary's out of the box. Lifts Chara's stick. Here comes Zetterberg against Bergeron. 2-on-1 with Cleary. Across to Cleary, who rams into Rask. And the puck goes to the far side. Detroit has killed the 3-on-5 situation. Cleary looking into the middle. Here's Quincy all the way up at the faceoff dot. Right on Rask, and he sticks it to the far side. Now Jordan Perron. Kelly taps the puck to Marchand. He pivots, top of the circle. The wrist shot wide on the glove side. Cleary taps back to Erickson. Up ahead through the seam for Alfredson, and the Bruins jump all over. Marchand closes on the backhand. Quincy tips the puck away. Marchand to Perron. It deflects past Kelly. Seidenberg there. Over to Markowski. The wrist shot off a body and bounces wide of the glove side. Post, and the crowd roars as the Bruins bring the effort. Detroit has gotten through a pivotal point in this game. Down two men in the Bruins with some great looks.
Now the Bruins set up for the potential one-timer from out high on both sides. Aguila and Char, they worked it in order to get a number of them. They just have no puck luck around the net right now.
A minute and 44 of attacking zone time during the 5-on-3. A minute and 44 out of a minute and 54. Here's Abdelkader and a stick save by Rask. It spins down. Kindle can't keep it in the zone because of Campbell's effort along with Payet. Weiss banks the puck off the end boards. It rattles to DeKaiser. Gets to Kindle. The puck pops up on him. Kindle quickly around for Miller, who deflects it up on edge. Let's go Bruins, the chant from the TD Garden crowd. High redirects the puck in deep. Danny DeKaiser with Campbell. But DeKaiser turns the post. Tries the stick handle out of the zone. Too much traffic. DeKaiser still on it. Boychuk stops him with the hit. Rask rattles it around. Boychuk with the hit on Glendening. Or rather, Lucic. Here's the one-timer from 2-2. It's wild and wide. Cromwell, D to D to Erickson. Erickson through the seam. Glendening, the backhand tap to the end boards. Rask right at the edge of the trapezoid. Krejci. Chara. Lucic tries to speed down the wing against 2-2, but he angles him into Erickson. Deflected pass. Chara looks for the wrist shot. Down past the circle. Chara goes around the goal. Glendening poking it away. Here's McQuaid with space. The drive. The puck appeared to split in two, but it was actually a stick or a piece of equipment that broke off. I don't know what that is down there behind the goal line. Cronwall.
Sometimes players have protective equipment around the boot of the shot block. Maybe that's something.
Yeah, it could be one of those woven carbon fiber foot guards. They're sort of form-fit. They go right over the boot of the skate. Tremendous action here in the third period. Chara with Smith straight ahead off the boards. DeKaiser controls. Zetterberg banks it for Datsyuk. He pivots it all the way behind Rask. Smith against Datsyuk. Bergeron comes over. Datsyuk goes for a tumble. Zetterberg at the blue line, keeping the puck in the attacking zone for the moment. But here's Erickson backing up, finding Chara going up the middle. Now can the Red Wings capitalize with Chara forward of the puck? Danny DeKaiser inside 10 minutes to go. DeKaiser works it to the red line. Seidenberg gets a piece of the pass. It rattles outside the line and back in. Offside against the Red Wings. Detroit kills off an expansive 5-on-3 situation and seizes control of the momentum. The Bruins miracle comeback is just ahead. Great service, great coverage, and a great price for auto, home, or life insurance.
Well, hard to argue really with the Bruins and what they've been able to do with the power play. They got a number of good looks here. They've had tremendous offensive zone time. One little wrinkle that we would add to the power play. Here's the Ginla. If you get a Ginla to drive in this area here towards the net and then have Chara slide in this way here, maybe you set yourself up for another one time. You get a Ginla a little closer to the net and you create some problems for that triangle defensively. Bruins kind of force-feeding the low play, really without the space that they were looking for. Maybe if Aguila has that net drive, it opens up something for Chara. And it gives you yet another weapon to use with that 5-on-3. But the Bruins got some really quality looks. Gustafson made a couple of stops, a couple of shot blocks, a couple of missed nets opportunities. Again, opportunistic. Detroit has been, Boston hasn't.
Jakob Kindle in on Rask. He'll have to take a defensive zone faceoff with Abdelkader gliding down the slot. Shots on goal are 26-26. Milan Lucic having some equipment prepared down in the tunnel. So we deduce that that broken whatever the heck it was down in the corner belonged to him. And they're either trying to fashion a new one or fix what he's got. We're hearing that he's got his skate off. It's amazing what Keith Robinson and the Bruins equipment staff can do on the fly.
Yeah, when that puck looked like it was split in two after the drive from the point, it had to do with Lucic's skate, I would assume, right, Kevin?
Yeah, so I guess it was ballistic material off of Lucic's skate. Krug with a huge effort to beat Kindle to the end boards, but now Detroit tries to turn it into transition. Thornton rotating back, snaps the puck in deep, and the Bruins pin their ears back and go in after it again. Kindle had it spring off his stick. 2-2 takes a big hit from Thornton, who knocks him down, much to the delight of the crowd.
Boychuk, it comes right back to Campbell, and his shot off a stick, up and out of play. 7:45 to
now
go
it's time
in
to
the game. Detroit 3, the Bruins 1 in a matinee at TD Garden.
Right after the game, Barry Peterson and I right back in these positions for Ace Ticket Bruins Overtime Live.
Yeah, we'll preview former Bruin Tim Thomas and the Florida Panthers, the Bruins' next opponent.
You'll also hear from Claude Julien and Ace Ticket Bruins Overtime Live after the game.
But first this, as the Bruins try to come from two down. Having seen the Patriots come back and the Red Sox come back yesterday. You got to do the game. Faceoff, Erickson jumping ahead, so the Bruins couldn't get a chance off the Krejci draw. Chara for Boychuk. Chara has Zetterberg nearby. Erickson steps around to Gimlet. Krejci gives it away to Bertuzzi, and a save by Rask, and Bertuzzi pulls Rask into the back of his neck, and Boychuk just plants his knee on Bertuzzi's chest.
That's going to be a penalty on Bertuzzi after a poor turnover by David Krejci. Bertuzzi in the blind spot makes the steal, attacks Rask. Rask makes a tremendous save right side of his body, but Bertuzzi just kept on going and made contact. That's got to be a penalty on Bertuzzi, isn't it?
Yeah, I think he's leaking. I think he might have caught the post with his eyebrow. The ice.
Maybe they're just saying that Boychuk pushed him in a Rask. He has his arms tied up, no chance to break his fall. I thought they were going to give a penalty, but second look on the replay, it looks like Boychuk helped him into a Rask.
Yeah. No way to control himself there. So he's going to have to go off for repairs. Once in a while you hear players talk about soft ice, not when your face is hitting it. Ton of time left in this game, but the Bruins need to cash in somewhat in the way that Detroit has this afternoon. And this is one of the guys who does it for them. Datsyuk finds the seam all the way through to Franz, and he turns and bangs the puck around behind Rask. Chara out to Marchand, drops it back to Boychuk. Boychuk rolls the puck down the wing. Marchand getting a chance in Lucic's spot as Lucic actually had the heel of his skate boot shattered by the point shot. And that was the debris that was in the corner. And I believe that's that high-tech carbon fiber stuff that is really kind of armor on the skates now for players. Lucic still in the tunnel waiting either for a new boot to be put on a blade or perhaps that one to be repaired. McQuaid, Alfredson knocks him down. Alfredson's going to go for a boarding penalty here. The Bruins will get the extra man on the ice as soon as Rask recognizes it. And now Rask moves to the Boston bench. Erickson pokes the puck through, but Smith can't maintain possession. Warning on Alfredson, 5:58 to go. The 5-on-3 was important. This penalty brings up a must-score power play. Krejci thrown out of the faceoff. And Glenn Denning wins it away from Lucic. So the Wings can waste a little bit more clock by driving it in. Half a minute gone on the power play already, and Krejci with a hop in his step sends it forward to Krug, who races up past the hash marks. The shot on Gustafsson. Travels around back of the goal. Cronwall clears but not out. Akinla back at the point. Lucic, high slot. The rocket goes off the end glass. Chara knocks it down, wins the puck battle against Cronwall. Now Akinla. Akinla trying to move around Glendenning, but Glendenning showing his value to this Wings team. He killed a lot of penalty time in Philadelphia a couple of nights ago, and now he's made a play here. Less than a minute to go with the Boston power play.
Bergeron. The pass off the back of Cleary's legs. Loose in front of the Detroit bench. Krug wins it over to Louis Erickson. Now Bergeron. Hard around into the zone. Bergeron picks off the errant clearing attempt. Krug hard across the zone. Smith tosses to Bergeron. To Krug. His drive goes off to Kaiser's legs. The centering attempt for Caron goes through the seam all the way back to Rask's end. Only 20 seconds to go. Smith. Louis Erickson. Caron's the man in front. Bergeron to Barkowski. The stick check from Drew Millen.
Now that sequence right there tells you exactly what Detroit's been able to do defensively. Even though Boston's generated some pretty good offensive pressure, stick position and shot blocking have been on display.
One shot on goal for a total of five on the power play this afternoon. 52 seconds of zone time for the Bruins, not nearly as much as they would have wanted. Barkowski wrists it toward goal. Cronwall gets body position on Campbell. Campbell comes back up with the puck. Barkowski's drive tipped in front. Kelly on the rebound. Still loose next to the crease. Barkowski trying to hurry it, but Zetterberg on the leg block. Barkowski whacks it away. Statsuk stops, pulls up, finds the puck, saucers to Zetterberg. Zetterberg through the slot, brings it back to Lashoff, moves along the line. Zetterberg kicks to the stick. Kelly ties him up. Zetterberg holds on the wing. Barkowski steers him into the ref. Zetterberg saucer pass to Alfredson. He's got Kindle left. Kindle closes the drive, goes over the stick side. Post and Karams 200 feet the other way.
And then you counter with a guy like Pavel Datsyuk, a playmaker. Just steps inside people. We saw him on the Zetterberg goal do that to Chari. Does it again coming across the blue line. And then an aerial pass intended to be gloved down by Zetterberg.
Lucic for Krejci. A little traffic jam for the Wings as they have a collision between Franzen and Lashoff. But the Bruins can't capitalize on that. Lucic with a big hit on Franzen. Bouncing puck. Abdelkader sprinting. Rask out. Huge collision. And Abdelkader is down. Now Krug comes over to kick the puck from between Rask's skates to the corner. Tuukka Rask, knowing there was going to be contact, but going out there fearlessly.
Like a defenseman pinching down. If you can't get the puck, you better take the man.
Krejci has Lucic middle. Can't get it through Cronwall. Cronwall. Abdelkader unable to clear the zone. Lucic spins it to Seidenberg, who had to turn the stick. Seidenberg off the end boards. Krejci gets knocked down on Erickson's little chuck. Now it's Lucic trying to skate away from Cronwall. Krejci has it along the kick plate. Tries to push out for a little bit of space, and Erickson won't let him get comfortable. Lucic slides it through to Krejci, a little too hot to handle, especially when engaged with Erickson. Krejci with the reach. Boychuk's rocket off the chest of Gustafsson. Lucic to Boychuk with a minute and a half to go. Rask still in the Boston goal. Seidenberg in the corner. Shields the puck from Anderson. Turns the other way on it. Seidenberg tries to sweep it in front. Lucic scores with a minute.
About this, just determination, desire, the will to get something done in the offensive zone. The Bruins have worked hard in the O zone most of this afternoon. You mentioned that Detroit's been opportunistic, Boston's been a little frustrated, even with great offensive zone time, and they get a break. That puck goes off the skate applicator right to Lucic, elevates on the backhand, but that's just hard work. Seidenberg doing the job. Usually when you're below the goal line and you're a defenseman, you're in your own zone in those situations trying to shake people. Well, it carries over to the offensive zone. Then it's Seidenberg getting the job done. Lucic hanging around the front of the net. That's where the goals are. And the Bruins have positioned themselves to do something a little miraculous.
Kelly snaps his stick. Boston face off against Datsyuk. Shot saved by Gustafsson. Rebound. Kelly temporarily in the Bruins playing without a goalie as Rask has gone to the bench for the extra skater. A minute to go in what has been a tremendously entertaining game at TD Garden on a Columbus Day afternoon. I will die.
Batson. Can't get it up the board past Kelly. Campbell cross ice to Seifert. The shot loose in the slot. Bodies flying all over the place. Huge contact right in front. Marchand back to Seidenberg. Seidenberg holds, sends it off the corner boards. It bounces around the goal line. Seidenberg on the half ball. Erickson has Boychuk. He loads up the drive, tipped, and it goes wide. Franzen off the wall, less than half a minute to go. Erickson has Seidenberg. Seidenberg, the slap pass goes all the way off the kick plate. Marchand, 20 seconds left. Boychuk's shot, double deflection. Kelly stops it for Marchand. He can't slug it in front. Quincy off the glass. Boychuk along the wall. Seidenberg less than 10. Erickson with 5. Throws it off of Franzen. A scramble near the blue line. Datsyuk. And the clock runs out. What a tremendous hockey game this afternoon at TD Garden. And Detroit had its legs and needed every bit of energy to hold off this Boston team.
And that's the word coming into today. You knew there'd be more energy to Detroit's effort than we saw the first time when they came in. And they did just enough to win this hockey game. And I think it's appropriate that it's a shot block at the very end by Detroit that prevents one more opportunity by Boston. Boston with the great pressure. Bruins did a lot of good things today. They had some breakdowns in front of their own net. And the opportunistic wings win this one-goal game as a result.
The Audi key play brought to you by your local New England Audi dealers. And symptomatic of that opportunism, it's a 1-1 game. The Bruins carrying an awful lot of play. And what looks like a relatively harmless play, Franzen finds the seam and Steven Weiss is there, and look where the shot goes. Up where Mama keeps the gluten-free cookies. Steven Weiss with the Audi key play. And the save of the game. Digital Federal Credit Union, what can DCU save you? Gustafson all over the place. A little snow angel action after Torrey Krug makes things happen in the slot. For Gustafson today, 25 saves. For Tuukka Rask, 27. A squeaker of a finish. A terrifically entertaining game. Detroit takes this one, Dale.
Well, I'll say this. I thought they had another comeback in them. The way the weekend is gone, I thought it was going to happen. Coming up on Ace Ticket, Bruins Overtime Live. Red Wings get revenge. They get a victory over the Bruins here this afternoon at the TD Garden. Claude Julien will go one-on-one with Jamie Erdahl. And the Bruins take on Thomas